Hey, what is up guys, my name is Cosmin and in today's video you'll learn how to design this illustration using Photoshop CC in just a few steps. I've already started sketching. The idea I'm trying to develop is to have a couple of colleagues work on a design sprint using a whiteboard. You can try coming up with a team activity and start sketching on a piece of paper or on your computer. If you don't want to try out a new idea, that's totally fine. You could just follow along on what I'm doing. You should find the initial sketch and the design files in the description below, and that should help you get started. But before I go any further, I'd like to give you more context on what I'm actually doing. Just to be clear, this project is a study on the illustration that I've seen on the Slack website. I wanted to explore them and understand how they are built. So the best way of doing it for me was to actually try to design a similar one. So basically reverse engineer their style, maybe get a glimpse of their process, and answer this question. How come by just looking at one, I can tell it's done for Slack? Well, the answer to that might be pretty simple because I browse Dribbble way too much. But I'm sure you've noticed this kind of compositions where people are working together on building an interface. That's something that's pretty popular now, at least with tech companies. And most of them look pretty much the same. And then I saw a set of illustrations done by Alice Lee and the UENO design team and Slack design team, and that made me reconsider if this is just a trend. What was so different about these illustrations? Well, first off, they feel timeless, and I'm pretty sure they'll look great in a few years too compared to most others, which I'm pretty sure will not stand the test of time. That's just my opinion. I just don't like gradients. For some reason, the first thing I'm thinking when I see them is a children's art book. Very simple shapes, dynamic and textured, and no one wants to see a stock photo of someone in a meeting in a website's header nowadays. I'm guessing that's considered lazy. I'm kidding, I do it all the time, so it shouldn't be a problem. Let's get back and analyze what do most of these illustrations have in common. In terms of composition, all of them are comprised of multiple people that are outside or inside, mostly inside, I'm guessing, because they want to show people working together in a workspace. They include plants, a pretty limited color palette, and sometimes you get to see animals in them. Now with people. People are always working together. They have at least one person in motion. Each person has a purpose or seems to have a purpose. Each person is engaged and looking somewhere. They're independent but helpful. The mood is pretty light. The light is pretty mood. And they're pretty tall. You've probably noticed I have very rough drawing skills, but with the initial sketch, I wanted to get a glimpse in how dynamic the scene can be. At this point, I'm still thinking I'll have the girl on the left hold a piece of paper, but that will change very soon. And using simple lines, I'll draw some stick figures, which will be the foundation of the whole composition. Using the direct selection tool, you can do adjustments along the way. On top of the stick figures, I've started having the main body shapes defined, and by adding elements, you start getting a better picture of what you should construct and what you should adjust. During the whole process, you'll probably end up with a lot of things looking very different than the initial sketch, unless you've already done this kind of illustration, which I have not. Always try to look for inspiration and imagine how the characters will be dressed before blocking in the shapes. After you're done with that, you can add a different shade of gray for each individual shape in order to properly understand the hierarchy of each one and arrange them. Let's bring in the colors I've previously sampled from the illustrations done for Slack and start applying them to my shapes. To apply a different color, you can double click on the thumbnail of each shape layer and you'll get the color picker. Afterwards, just experiment and try different color combinations till you're happy with something. What you're seeing right now are the late stages of figuring out what color should their clothes have and what color should I use for the background elements. You've probably noticed that they're using something like a halftone pattern throughout all of their illustrations, and that gets used as a highlight, it gets used as a shadow, or even just decoration. So I'll try to create a new brush, and hopefully you can follow along with me. Started off with a small grid made out of lines, and I've locked the layer up, and using the brush tool, I'll go over each intersection and create a small dot. Each dot can be different weights, it doesn't really matter. When you have a full row, you can start duplicating and rotating to make sure that the pattern isn't repeating itself too much. Merge those initial layers and duplicate them. I've arranged them in a crisscross pattern, and once I'm happy with it, I'll make a selection of the whole thing, go to edit, and select define brush preset. You'll then have to give it a name, and now you have a new brush. Let's give this a go and start adding it to the illustration now that I've started shading and adding details to it. At this point in the illustration, I've started adding small details to the clothes of the characters, and you can probably tell that I've used a charcoal-like brush to make the lines seem more inconsistent. I just use it as a brush and go over it, but just barely intersecting with the lines and giving them a bit of texture, since having very clear lines moved this away from the children's book style seen in the previous illustrations. For the eyes and the mouth, I'll use simple shapes created with the pen tool. For the mouth, it will probably be a stroke line, and I'll keep it around 3 pixels. Once I selected it, you can find the color or use the color picker to sample one straight from the illustration. And just like the other characters, I'll try to give it a bit more personality to each one. So I'll add some random hair strays for each character. And that's something that's being used pretty often, giving them a less clean look. Here's how the illustration looks, and I've done a couple of changes to try to make it a bit better. First off, I brought all of the characters closer together, then I reshaped the head of the guy on the right, gave some of the clothes some waves to make them look more dynamic, and fixed the proportions of the girl on the left. So let's recap all of the steps. I started out by trying to figure out the poses for each character. Then I drew some stick figures to those poses and made small adjustments. I've added very basic shapes on top of those stick figures, and that led me to these shapes, which added a bit more character. Apply different colors for each base shape till you find something you're happy with, and add in the details that give the illustration some depth. In the end, take a break and look at it after a couple of minutes and see what stands out and fix it. When I put my illustration next to the ones used by Slack, I can tell a couple of things that I've missed, but it was a fun experiment, and hopefully this tutorial helped you see how following a couple of rules can help you create a series of illustrations. Hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more. Till next time, take care guys, bye!